They smiled, they giggled, they laughed out loud. They jiggled, jiggled, and they rolled, and they roared. Alexander had a very bad day. Nothing would ever go his way. Stop now, everyone, I'm not having fun. Australia's a place for me.
Good evening, welcome, welcome everyone. It's so good, as always, to see everyone come out. And I know there's so much to do, but this is going to be exciting. I got a preview earlier today, and they're very, very excited to present to you tonight. So, without further ado, here come our second and third graders.
Second grade.
Oh, we also ask that you please stay the entire time. It's only 25 minutes. Thank you. Good evening. Here we have our fabulous second graders, smiling second graders, right? Awesome. They are going to do for you a porcupine named Fluffy this evening. Here we go. When Mr. and Mrs. Porcupine had their first child, they were delighted. Now he needed a name. Should they call him Spike? No, Spike was too common. Should they call him Lance? No, Lance sounded too fierce. Should they call him Needle Rooser? No, Needle Rooser was too long. Prickles? Pokey. Quillen? Then together they had an idea.
Let's call him Fluffy.
It's such a pretty name. Fluffy.
Clouds are fluffy, I'll be a cloud.
But he couldn't stay up. He tried soaking in a bubble bath for 45 minutes, but he did not become fluffy. He became soggy.
They should have named me Gooey.
fluffy marshmallows. He rolled in shaving cream and feathers. He even tried to become a bunny. But the truth remained, Fluffy wasn't. One afternoon, Fluffy set out for a walk, trying to think of ways to become Fluffy. Before long, he met a very large rhinoceros.
Grr, I'm gonna give you a rough time.
Fluffy didn't know what a rough time was, but he didn't like the sound of it at all.
What's your name, small prickly one?
What's your name, small prickly one? What's your name, small prickly one? What's your name, small prickly one? What's your name, small prickly one?
Fluffy.
The rhinoceros smiled. He giggled. Then he laughed out loud. He rolled on the ground. He jiggled and slapped his knees. He roared with laughter.
He smiled. He giggled, he laughed out loud. He jiggled, jiggled, and he rolled, and he roared.
A porcupine named Fluffy?
Fluffy was embarrassed, but he tried to be polite.
And what is your name?
Ha! I can't say it.
Hubert?
No, ha! 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 Oh, help, I just can't say it. I'm laughing so hard.
An older maybe Herman?
No, it's hippo.
Thank you. went to sleep with gum in my mouth, and now there's gum in my hair. And when I got out of bed this morning, I tripped on my skateboard and by mistake dropped my sweater in the sink while the water was running.
Alexander could tell it was going to be a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day.
Terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day.
At breakfast, Anthony found a stingray car kit in his cereal box. Nick found a junior undercover agent code ring in his cereal box, but all Alexander found was
breakfast cereal. I think I'll move to Australia.
Australia's the place for me.
In the car room, Miss Gibson let Becky have a seat by the window. Audrey and Ellie got seats by the window too.
I said I was being scrunched. I said I was being smushed. I said if I don't get a seat by the window, I am going to be sick.
But no one even answered. Alexander could tell it was going to be a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day.
Terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day.
At school, Mrs. Dickens liked Paul's picture of the sailboat better than my picture of the invisible castle.
At singing time, Alexander, you're singing too loud.
At counting time,
Alexander, you skipped 16.
Aw, who needs 16?
Alexander could tell it was going to be a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day.
Paul said,
Alexander, you're not my best friend anymore. You are my third best friend.
Oh yeah? I hope you sit on a tack. I hope you get a double-decker strawberry ice cream cone and the ice cream part falls off the cone part and lands in Australia.
Australia's the place for me.
Philip Parker's lunch bag had two cupcakes in it. Albert got a Hershey bar with almonds in his lunch bag. Paul got a Jolly Roll with coconut sprinkles on top.
I guess Mom forgot to put my dessert in my lunch bag.
Poor Alexander, it definitely was a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day.
Terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day.
After school, Alexander's mom took Alexander and his brother and his sister to the dentist. Dr. Fields only found one cavity. Too bad it was in Alexander's tooth. Come back next week, Alexander, and I'll fix it.
Next week, I'm going to Australia.
Australia's the place for me.
Poor Alexander. The elevator closed on his foot, and Anthony made him fall in the mud. And then he cried, and Nick called him a crybaby.
Then Alexander punched Nick for calling him a crybaby, and Mom scolded him for being muddy and for fighting.
I am having a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day.
Terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day.
And no one even answered.
And guess what else? Lima beans for dinner.
Alexander hated lima beans.
Kissing on TV.
Alexander hated kissing.
My bath was too hot. I got soap in my eyes. I lost my marble down the drain, and I had to wear my railroad train pajamas.
Alexander hates his railroad train pajamas.
Nick took back the pillow he gave me. My nightlight burned out. I bit my tongue.
The cat wanted to sleep with Anthony, not Alexander.
Alexander had a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day.
Terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day.
Alexander's mom says some days are just like that.
Even in Australia.
Australia's the place for me. Alexander had a very bad day.
much for coming tonight, and thank you for having such wonderful children.